Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group 10. We will present our ISAS to the title IO System. Before we start, I want to introduce for our member. The first is me, Muhammad Ghazi Aska, and my brother, Abdul Latif Afifuddin Daulay. And in our ISAS, we have four highlights. And the first is introduction, and the second is basic theory, and the third is problem analysis, and the last conclusion and suggestion. And the first is introduction. The first is background. Today, in human life, electronic devices have become very commonplace. Even children from a young age have used them. Where everything is electronic, we also need to connect between the device for our various daily needs. For example, devices that are interconnected with internet signal use input and output process so that we can connect with other devices wirelessly or connect devices such as keyboards, mice, printers, etc. And the computer system will not be useful without the equipment inputs and outputs. I/O operations are obtained through a number of external devices that provide tools for data exchange between the external environment and the computer. We have often used the I/O system, but we don't know more about what it is. Here we will discuss what is I/O system, are with their various types, and the importance of knowing them in order to facilitate electronic process and optimize performance, so that the desired hull doesn't occur. And the second is writing objective. The purpose of this ISAS are, the first is explain about what is I/O system. The second is to understand about I/O system and to use. And the third is explain about types in I/O system. And the third is problem domain. Accordance with the ISAS, authors will discuss about the first is history of I/O system, second usage on every device, and the third types of I/O system. And the last is writing methodology. The method that we use to write this ISAS is from collecting online information, articles, and journal. And the next is basic theory for our brother is Latif Afifuddin Daulay. Or present.
In the first topic in this presentation, I will briefly explain what an I/O system. I/O system means input and output system. In computing, is a communication process between a computer and the outside world. Input refers to the signals or instruction sent to the computer, and for the output refers to the signals sent out from the computer. This term is also known as I/O operation, which reference the input and output action. And there are three types of I/O system. First, sensory input consisting of digital and analog. Digital by using data signals in the form of pulse that undergo sudden change and have magnitudes of 0 and 1. And for the analog is a signals that use data in the form of waves that have a continuous value. And for the second is control output. An I/O control system aims to provide assistance to users to enable them to access files, regardless of the details of storage characteristics and times. And for the last of this type is data transfer, consisting parallel and serial, which is where serial transmission requests one channel to communicate and transfer data, while parallel transmission requests multiple channels. Serial transmission is used for long distance communication, whereas parallel transmission is used for shorter distance.
And the next is problem analysis, and the first is history of I/O system. In 1868 and in 1887, it was produced and marketed by the Remington Company. The keyboard used today is a QWERTY type. In 1973, this keyboard was inaugurated as an ISO standard keyboard. The number of keys on this keyboard is 104 keys. The keyboard now, has several types of ports, namely serial port, PS2, USB, and wireless. And in 1981, Barry Richard Lyon, who worked at Xerox PARC, invented the first optical mouse, and a year later, Steve Chris developed an optical mouse that requires the help of a special mouse pad, a pad to detect sensors in motion. Actually, there were many developments and innovation in mouse device in the era of the 1980 to the 2000. And the second is input-output management, often also called the device manager, which provides a common device driver so that I/O operation can be uniform. An example is a user using the same operation to read files on hardware, CD-ROM, and floppy disk. The I/O system consists of first buffer system, which temporarily holds data from OR to I/O device. Second, spooling, which performs scheduling of system I/O use to make it more efficient. And the third is drivers for specific hardware that provides drivers to perform detailed operation for specific hardware.
For the third topic, I will discuss about application I/O interface. In computing, an interface is a shared boundary where two or more separate components of computer system exchange information. Exchange can occur between software, computer hardware, peripheral device, humans, and combination of both. User application access to wide variety of different devices done by via layering and through encapsulation of all tool specific code into device drivers. While the application layer is provided with interfaces that are common to all or at least general categories of device. And from this picture, as seen in the presentation, here is a description of process from input to output, which start from the kernel to the subsystem, in which there are several parts, such including sequencing, buffering, caching, and each other, then continues to the driver and is processed to the hardware.
And the last is conclusion and suggestion. The conclusion is we can get is that the input and output system that we now also have some structure or function in them again. So that by knowing them, we can be more efficient in their use. And suggestion, our ISAS is far from perfect. And if anything is lacking, we are ready to take criticism for our leaders and will be our correction to improve the quality of our next ISAS and in profit. Maybe this is our present. Thank you for attention. Last I say, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.